This video will explain how to use the Measure Foresight tool within the Measure app of Leica Captivate. This useful tool allows one or more foresights to be easily and quickly established, which can then be used for the next total station setup. Let's assume the total station has already been set up using the set orientation method, and we have accessed the Measure app and have measured some topo points. We now decide we want to measure a foresight point. That is, measure a point over which we later want to set up the total station. Because we want to use it as a setup point and therefore should be measured to a higher accuracy, we want to measure the point multiple times, turning angles from the backside. To access the Measure Foresight tool, we press FN and then F6 Tools and then choose Measure Foresight. In the Measure Foresight panel, we firstly define the measurement sequence, and if automatic aiming is turned on, if we want the measurements to be made automatically. In the Quality Control page tab, we can also define if we should be prompted for possible errors. The Define the Backsight screen only appears if the current setup was made using the Set Orientation or Known Backsight method. This allows you to define if the current backsight should be used as the reference point, or if it is needed to define a new reference point. The reference point is the point from which angles will be turned when measuring to the new foresight point. We will choose to use the current backsight point as the reference point. Pressing OK then accesses the panel where we can define the location of the foresight point. This means to make the first measurement to the foresight point. We enter the point ID and the target height of the foresight point. We can now define how many sets should be measured to the foresight point. We will choose to measure 3 sets. We can also assign a feature code to the foresight if wanted. We aim at the foresight point and press measure. A message now appears which allows us to choose if we want to establish a second foresight point. It could be we want to measure more than one foresight point from where we later want to set up the total station. We will not do this, we simply press done. The instrument will now turn and measure to the backsight and turn and measure to the foresight point in the order and number of times as previously defined. Once completed, we access the Point Results panel where we can check the results. For each foresight which was measured, we can see the number of sets measured to the foresight and the number used, the averaged horizontal angle, vertical angle and distance values, the standard deviation and spread. Pressing F3 Sets allows us to see more details on the individual sets of measurements and disable any sets we are not happy with. Pressing F2 Add Sets would allow us to make more measurements to the foresight if needed. Once we are satisfied with the result, we can press OK. This stores the foresight point to the job and we return to the Measure app. There is some extra information which may be useful to know. Firstly, we will access data management. A nice shortcut to do this is to tap the title line of the panel and we directly enter the data management panel. We can see here the foresight we just measured. Let's press F3 Edit to look at some details. Pressing F5 More shows the instrument and source metadata and then also the class. Notice the class is adjusted. Secondly, the Measure Foresight results are imported into Leica Infinity. Here it would be possible to create and adjust a traverse from the foresights measured in the field. And in addition, the Measure Foresight results can be exported directly from Leica Captivate using the usual data export methods. The Measure Foresight tool allows one or more foresights to be easily and quickly established, which can then be used for the next total station setup. And thanks for watching.